very, very crucial. But you will understand that in Hebrew, kneel sounds the same as to bless. Actually, in Hebrew, it is wire break, and then blessing is barak. So this man believed in God's promises because God had promised him, but also it was a sign of worship, making his camels bow down. Here we are learning, the writer of the passage is trying to draw our attention that when we arrive at the proper place, it is all part of the blessing. We cannot just move. If we arrive at the place, because this man knew that women draw from this well at this time of the evening, so he comes, and when he had reached the well, he made them bow. I want to believe he also bowed. Mean that every time we are moving on in our life and reach this place, we should always remember it was all part of a divine blessing. God's hand was in every event as you came towards that destination that he is taking you. Verse 12 says, "Oh God," this man prays, he's praying, "the God of my master Abraham, please grant me success today and show loving kindness to my master." Now, no, this unnamed servant is the first person in scripture that has prayed, that has ever prayed for divine guidance at a critical juncture. I don't know any other person in scripture before him that would pray for divine guidance. This man had a lot of things on his head to do, but now we see he's praying for divine guidance. He says, "Oh Lord, the God of my master Abraham, please grant me success today and show loving kindness to my master." We are supposed to seek divine guidance at every decision. Could be relationship, could be business, could be choice of, a lot of all things. We need to seek divine guidance. If it were me or any other person here, the master is very rich, he's old, and then his son wants a wife, I would just organize a Miss Mesopotamia beauty contest. And then I tell all the girls to come and model. Then I pick the best. That's what we will do in our human understanding. Then you pick the best. I've heard about this king of Swaziland. That's what they do. They make all the girls line up, the virgins, and then he picks the best. Maybe this guy would have done that. He could afford it because his master was wealthy. But he didn't do that. He was praying. Say, "Oh Lord, God of my master, grant me success so that I pick the right person for my master's wife." You know? So it is a very big lesson that we pick, that whatever juncture we are taking on in life, we need to seek God's guidance. Are you praying about decisions you're making regarding relationships or your business or your work or your family? It is our wake-up call to pray for divine guidance for every bit of this. He also says, "God, show loving kindness to his master." Remember, loving kindness in Hebrew it is interpreted as hesed. It means God's covenantal loyalty. God had made a covenant with Abraham, the Abrahamic covenant. So this man is saying, "Show loving kindness. Show your loyalty to this covenant because you told my master that you're going to bless him. He said that he's going to have descendants that fill the whole earth, that are like stars in the sky. Please show, come faithful to this covenant." So that's what he means by show loving kindness. Abraham's servant can pray with bold confidence because he knows that the God of Abraham is faithful to his promises. He had promised and he knew that he would fulfill. So he says, "Show." That's bold. "God, show loving kindness to my master." Now, it's interesting. Culturally, it was a normal act of hospitality and also giving water to travelers in Israel or even in other parts of the world. But the idea that a woman would also provide water for 10 thirsty camels, that beats understanding. Someone has seen a camel here. Okay, in the movies, they're not very common here. A camel, they say it takes about 15 gallons of water in one go, you know? And then remember, this